Hi, this is Carolina, and I'm going to do a tutorial on how to hoop behind the body in peacock tail. This is what that looks like from the front. And this is what that looks like from the back. It helps to have a lightish hoop that is small enough so that it doesn't touch the ground when you're holding it behind your back. The bigger the hoop is, the higher you have to hold your hand up your back, and that means you have to be more flexible. So the bigger your hoop is, the more flexibility it requires to get it high enough so that it's going to clear the ground. You can do it, just got to work on that shoulder flexibility. If you're on my circles of joy page on Facebook, it has some really good yoga sequences on there for opening up the shoulders that I recommend all hoopers do. I think they're really good. So, other things to know in addition to the size and the lightness is that the hoop is going in an outside circle, meaning that when you're holding it behind you and at the top of its circle, it's falling to the outside. So it's got to be doing an outside circle to allow you to do the hand turn. So right now my thumb is pointing up, my thumb is pointing down, it's coming behind my back, and it's pointing up again. I'll show you that from the front. And note that while you can do this move with one hand like you just saw me doing, it has a tendency to make the plane change so that it flops over your opposite shoulder and messes up. So using two hands is going to be probably the best option for a nice clean move. But if you're not that flexible yet, I'll show you a couple of cheats that will help you. So, outside circles, thumbs up, down, and up again. So, I would love to be able to put my upper hand into the hoop so that my fingers are back to back and my wrists are against the small of my back. And it's like I'm shaking hands with somebody like this. This can be challenging when you first start doing it because we have a tendency to lean over, and if you lean over, the hoop is going to hit your butt and it's going to mess it up. So you want to stay completely upright. While you're doing this, you may find that you have a tough time getting the backs of your hands together in the small of your back. I did when I first started learning. So, first cheat, you can lay one hand flat on top of the other one. So if I just stay here and I'm sweeping flat instead of my thumb pointing up, I lay my other hand on top of it or below it, and now I've got both hands and they're flat. So, this might be a good first step before you start working up into making your hands be together. Another thing, another little trick that I've found is when you first start hooping with this, it takes a while to get your posture right because we're not used to having our hands back behind us and up and hooping. So I find that being able to have my hoop a little farther away from my body makes it not hit me as much while I'm learning. But the thing about that is that if you just got your hand away from your body, it's moving all over the place and you're going to lose it. So what I do is I take one hand and I put it behind my body and it's against my back so that it's steady. Then I take the other wrist and I put it in the C of the first hand so that it actually holds my hoop a little farther away from my body. It gives me a chance to figure out what I'm doing back here. So I'll do that for you from three different angles. This one, holding my wrist. As long as my other wrist is against my back, my hoop is still somewhat stable, and all I have to worry about is up and down. I don't have to worry about the fact that my hoop is also moving forward and backwards. Here's what it looks like from behind. And you can go ahead and put this one back here if you want to have it ready. And here's what it looks like from the other side. back and down. This will keep you upright. It will give you a lot more space behind you. For hooping in, and it will make it a lot less likely that you touch your planes or box yourself in the back of the head or you box yourself in the bottom. So, okay, I guess that's all there really is to say about this little move. It's a little move, it takes some practice to do, but once you have it, it looks beautiful just to be able to stand here like this and hoop. And you could even leave it on one hand and take one other hand out and do something pretty with it. So, okay.